Hey everyone, so today we are going to talk about improper integrals of type 2. So in my earlier lecture we talked about type 1, and before that we saw a lecture on introduction to improper integrals. So I hope you have seen that lecture, because there I have told you that why this came into picture, that why Riemann theory can't be applied over here. So my strong suggestion is you please have a look, link you can find in the description. So after that, session or in that lecture I gave you a question. I ask you, what is the integral of this function is 1 upon root x. So now what many of you might have done, so let me just write it down over here. What many of you have done is may have done, so you must have taken x raised to minus half, that means root x in the numerator, and then you would have applied this minus half plus 1 upon minus half plus 1, 0 to 1, and then you would have said this is 2, this is half, so 2 root 1 minus root 0, so answer is 2. Many of you might have done this, and if I ask you the reason, what you will say? Oh, because why this is the step? Because this is the antiderivative and here you have applied FTC2. Okay, so that's the reason you can give me over here. But is this a valid reason? Because what does FTC2 says? It says that your function has to be continuous on the closed and the bounded domain. Is your function continuous? What is your function? 1 upon root x. What is the domain? 0 to 1. Is the function continuous in this domain? Answer is no. 0 is the problematic point. So since it's not continuous function in the given domain, you cannot apply FTC over this interval 0 to 1. So what one should do? So see, this was the interval 0 to 1 and 0 was the problematic point. So what you do the same technique which you did for type 1. So in our earlier lecture we saw that infinity was the problem. So you remove infinity for temporary basis, you bring in the variable b and take the help of limit. You do the same thing over here. 0 is the problematic point. You bring some variables c into the picture and then you integrate from c to 1. Now you can integrate this function from c to 1, not an issue, because function is defined everywhere in this domain c to 1, where c is something positive on the right side of 0, because 0 was the only problematic point. So here in this domain there is no problem. So what you do is you integrate in this domain. So if I try to do that, so what I'm doing is I'm doing integrating c to 1 x raised to minus half dx. Is the domain bounded? Yes. Is the function continuous on this domain? Yes. So you can apply FTC2. So what does this say? This is 2 root x, because this is the antiderivative c to 1. And this is nothing but 2 root 1 minus root c. Fine? Okay, so we integrated from c to 1. Now what will you take? You wanted the integral at 0 to 1. So obviously what you will do? You will take limit c approaching to 0. So I will write this as, so this is the definition of improper integral. You approach c going to 0. Many author also write c approaching to 0 plus, because we are approaching 0 from right hand side. So it's okay. So this is my definition. Then here also you have limit c going to 0 plus. Here also you are having limit c going to 0 plus. And now you apply the limit. So 2 into 1 minus 0. So 2 is the answer. Luckily for that and this, both way we got the same answer, but you may not get the same answer always. Okay. And ignore about the answer. The way you were doing that itself is wrong. You cannot apply FTC2 if it is unbounded domain. So that step, there was no justification to that step when you apply the limits 0 to 1 without considering this thing. Okay. So that was not a logical way to prove. So this is the logical way to prove. Okay. So the idea is same as that of improper integral type 1. You remove the problematic point, you introduce the limit, and then you can apply Riemann theory. So what I'm saying is, if you have an improper integral of type 2, you do the same thing. You apply the concept of limit, and what we did in the earlier case, you approach to c going to the problematic point. In earlier case it was 0, so I'm writing c going to 0. So you introduce limit and you take the variable c to the problematic point, and once you do that, you are in the world of Riemann integration. So you can apply Riemann theory, you can apply FTC2, and once you do that, you again reapply your limit C going to whatever the problematic point. So that's how the transition we are doing. Okay, so it's the same thing that we did for type 1. Okay, so now that's what the idea is. Now let me give you a proper definition and then we will see 2-3 some unique examples. So here is the definition. So it says that if you have an integral of a function that becomes an infinite at a point within the interval of integration. So like 1 upon root x was becoming infinite at 0. So if you have such a scenario, then there can be three possibilities. Either it is becoming infinite at the left hand point or at the right hand point or in between the interval. So we will define for all the three cases. So if it is continuous on open close AB and it is discontinuous at A, means f of A is infinite, then how do you define this integration? So what to do is, again, what is the problematic point? A is the problematic point. So remove the problematic point, keep this B as it is, and limit C approaching to A f of x dx, the same way which we did for the previous example. And as you can see, the interval is A to B, my C will be somewhere on the right of A, so I can take C approaching to A plus, just for the convenience that you know that your variable is not on the left of A, it is on the right of A. Okay, now suppose B is the problematic point. That means what? Your function is continuous on close A and open B, and at B it is discontinuous. That means taking the value infinite. So now since B is the problematic point, so you replace your B by some variable D, whatever you like, and then you take limit D approaching to B f of x dx. Okay, now in the interval A to B, where my D will lie? It will lie on the left of B, and D will approach to B from left hand side. So to be preciseness, one can write D approaching to B minus. That means D is approaching B from left hand side. So this is the scenario when one of the endpoints is the problematic point. And now suppose if the problematic point is within the interval, so at C, where C belongs to open interval AB, you have a problematic point. So what you do? You, since C is the problematic point which is in between the interval, so you split your integral at C. Integral A to C plus integral C to B f of x dx. So now this becomes the first type, in type 2, the first definition, and this is the second definition in type 2. Just now we wrote 1 and 2. And you know how to solve. Take the limit for each of them, solve them separately, call this as I1, call this as I2, and solve them. So if both comes out to be finite, we say the integral converges. If one of them comes out to be infinite, we say integral diverges. So that's the definition we have. Now let's see some examples. So now here is the integral. Now as you can see, what is the problematic point over here? You can see that 2 is the problematic point, right? And 2, you can see it is within the interval. So let me call this as I. So how I will write my I as integral 0 to 2 dx upon x minus 2 raised to 2 by 3 plus integral 2 to 3 dx upon x minus 2 raised to 2 by 3. Now you solve one by one. You call this as I1, call this as I2. Okay, so let's play with I1 first. So integral 0 to 2 dx upon x minus 2 raised to 2 by 3. Fine. Now here 2 is the problematic point. So you remove your 2. How will you remove your 2? By bringing a variable some C into the picture. And you take limit C approaching to 2. Now in 0 to 2, you will approach 2 from left hand side. So 2 minus. And here you have dx upon, or you can say this is x minus 2 raised to minus 2 by 3 dx. Now what is this integral? Now the domain is finite. Function is defined over the domain. So what is this? This is limit C approaching to 2 minus. That means from left hand side, this is x minus 2 minus 2 by 3 plus 1 upon minus 2 by 3 plus 1, which is 1 by 3 upon 1 by 3, and this is 0 to C, right? And when you apply, you have 3 C minus 2 raised to 1 by 3 minus 3 minus 2 raised to 1 by 3. And what is this? Limit C approaching to 2 minus. So this will become 0, and this is what? Minus 3 minus 2 raised to 1 by 3. Fine. Now let's try to solve I2. So for I2, we have 2 to 3 dx upon this. Now again 2 is the problematic point. So remove that 2 by introducing a variable and then C will approach to that 2. Now I have 2 to 3. Now where has to be my C? It has to be on the right of C. So C will approach to 2 from right hand side. And this is the integral. Okay. Now the domain is bounded. Function is continuous over the given domain. So limit C approaching to 2 from right hand side. This is 3x minus 2 raised to 1 by 3 C to 3. Right? And what this will be? So when you apply the upper and lower limit, limit C approaching to 2 plus 3 into 3 minus 2. So 1 raised to 1 by 3 minus C minus 2 raised to 1 by 3. This is what you have when you apply upper and lower limit. Now you take limit C approaching to 2. So this becomes 0. So you have 3 as the answer. So this is the value of I2. Just now we found the value of I1. So when you do I1 plus I2, you get the answer of this integral. So since both of them are finite, therefore their addition is finite. Therefore this improper integral converges. So whenever you have a bounded domain, but at some point within the domain, function is going towards plus minus infinity, then you split that integral at that point and then you apply the definition and you get the answer. Now let's go for a different example. Now here is the integral you have. Now again you can see 0 is the problematic point which is within the domain, right? So how will you write this? Integral minus 1 to 0 plus integral 0 to 4, right? Okay, so let's play one by one. Let me call the first integral as I1. So integral dx upon root of mod x. Okay, good. Now again, what is the problematic point? 0 is the problematic point. So remove 0 by introducing a variable c. And then you're approaching c going to 0 from right hand side. Dx upon root of. Now what is mod x? It is either x or minus x. Now here in the domain, I am in the negative side of the real line. So my x is negative. So whenever our x is negative, what is mod x? It is minus x. Okay. And because of this, this makes sense. See, it has to be minus x. I mean, where our x is negative. So for example, if your x is minus half, which is within the domain, then x is minus half. So minus of minus is plus half. So this is root of plus half. Okay, so don't get confused that, okay, I'm taking root of minus. My x is negative, so this minus is a boon to me, like it's making this minus into positive. Okay, so this is what I have. Now it's easy. There is not a big deal. You just solve this integral. This is what? Minus x raised to minus half dx. You bring this in the numerator. And what is this? You have limit. This is integration is minus x raised to, so 2 minus x raised to half into minus 1, because you have minus x, right? And then you take minus 1 to c, and then you take minus 2 minus c raised to half minus 2, x is minus 1, so 1 raised to half. And when you solve this, you get minus 2 as an answer, because this limit becomes 0. So this is minus 2. Okay, so this is minus of minus plus 2. Okay, good. And then x is minus 1, so minus minus plus 1. So I have plus 2 as an answer for I1. Now let's try to solve I2. Now here for I2 also, my 0 was the problematic point. So you remove 0 by introducing a variable d. You can keep c also, not a problem. And then I mean 0 to 4. So d is on the right of this. So it will be, I don't know, in earlier case whether I wrote C approaching to 0 plus or minus, it should be 0 minus. And here D approaching to 0 plus. And what is mod x? So when I am in the positive interval. So my mod x is nothing but x only. And what is this? Limit D approaching to 0 plus. This is nothing but 2 root x D to 4. So what is this? Limit D approaching to 0 plus. This is 2 into 2 minus 2 root D. And the answer is 4. So 2 plus 4, so this integral converges to 6. So that's how we will solve this mod related problems. So I hope the idea is clear. Now let me give you a couple of homework problems. So here are the 3 homework problems for you. So again, you can see here 1 is the problematic point. So you will split this as 0 to 1 and 1 to 2. And then again, this will be for x less than 1. This will be minus of x minus 1. and from 1 to 2 this will be x minus 1 only. Okay, so that's the hint for first. For second, again the same thing, minus 1 to 0 plus 0 to 4. For minus 1 to 0 this will be minus x, from 1 to 0 to 4 it will be plus x. I think this one will diverge, one of the integral will come out to be infinite. I'm not sure, you can give a try. And the last one, minus 1 to 1 dx upon x raised to 2 by 3. Now many people have habit that since in the type 1, in my earlier lecture we saw the p integral test, that dx upon x raised to p converges for p greater than 1, diverges for p less equal 1. So people, what they do is they don't see this here, they will say 2 by 3 which is less than 1, it diverges. No, that is for a to infinity where a is positive. Here you don't have infinity thing. Okay, so don't apply p integral test over here. Okay, so be careful. So yeah, again here also you have to split minus 1 to 0 and 0 to 1 and you have to solve them individually. I think this will come out to be finite. But okay, yeah. So these are the three homework problems you are supposed to solve. And do comment your answer in the comment section. If you have any other problem, then that also you can ask me in the comment section. And if everything is clear, then yes, do not forget to like, share and subscribe. Thank you.